శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ, నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఆటోనోమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్, ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
Hello students, good morning. In the last class, we have discussed about the characteristics of op-amp, and today we are going to discuss about the characteristics and specifications of op-amp. So coming to the characteristics of op-amp, so the first characteristic is input offset voltage. So what is this offset voltage? So first we are going to discuss about what is this offset voltage. So when we are considering an op-amp, so this is an operational amplifier. If both the input terminals are grounded, op-amp is having two input terminals. That is, one is inverting input terminal and another one is non-inverting input terminal. If both the input terminals are grounded, then output must be zero. Grounded means we are making the both the inputs as zero, so the output must be zero. But practically the output may not be zero. So this will happen. Why? Because due to some mismatch in the components, internal components. So for that reason, we are going to give a small amount of voltage, that is input offset voltage. So we are going to give a small amount of voltage to non-inverting terminal, and we are making, by adjusting this voltage, we are making output voltage to zero. So this voltage, whatever the voltage we are going to take to make the output voltage zero when two terminals are grounded, is nothing but input offset voltage. So when both the input terminals are grounded, the output voltage must be zero. However, practically it will be not zero. So to make adjustment of such voltages, so we are applying a small voltage at the input terminals to make the output voltage zero. This is called input offset voltage, and it will be given by VIOS is equal to the difference between the two input voltages, that is V1 minus V2. So this is input offset voltage. And coming to the next characteristic, so this is input bias current. So biasing current, so input bias current, what will be the this biasing current, we will see. So operational amplifier is having two input terminals. So whenever operational amplifier, the two input terminals does not draw any input current, that is ideally the two input terminals must not draw any current, but practically they draw a small amount of current. So see here, ideally no current is drawn from the input terminals, but practically a small value of DC current to bias the input terminals, input transistors is needed. So that is the two terminals we are having is, one is inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal. So for inverting terminal, the current is taken as IB minus, and for non-inverting terminal, the current is taken as IB plus. So bias current, because this is the bias current, we are indicating I in suffix with B. So IB minus and IB plus for inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal. But both these two are not equal. So IB minus is different from IB plus. So this can be, the bias current can be given by the average of two input currents, nothing but the average of two input currents. Here you can see that. So IB is equal to IB plus plus IB minus divided by 2, the average of two input currents. Typically it is around 500 nanoamperes. So here you can see very small amount of current, that is nothing but practically it is nanoamperes, means it is very small amount of current will flow through the operational amplifier when it is operating, when it is used for different applications. So this is called input bias current. Next parameter is input offset current. So what is this input offset current? And it is indicated by IOS. So IIOS generally. So bias current compensation will work if both currents are equal. If both currents are equal, there will be no problem for us. The transistor cannot be identical, but these two currents are not equal. Why? Because whatever the transistors we are using inside the operational amplifier, that is, as we have discussed that in a differential amplifier, we are using two transistors of identical parameters, but practically identical parameters may not be possible. Because of that, there will be a change in the current, bias current. That is, the inverting input terminal current is different from the non-inverting input terminal current. This is non-inverting input terminal current and this is inverting input terminal current. So these two is different. These two are different. So that can be obtained. The difference between those two, we are calling that as input offset current. That is, IOS is nothing but the difference between the two input currents. So it will be around 200 nanoamperes. This is also a small amount of current. And coming to the next parameter, open loop voltage gain. So it is voltage gain. You know that voltage gain means that that is nothing but output voltage to the input voltage. Here for an operational amplifier, so we are using the output voltage, we are indicating output voltage as V0 and we are indicating input voltage as VD. VD is nothing but difference between two input voltages, that is V1 minus V2, that is differential voltage. So the output voltage, open loop voltage gain is given by AOL is equal to V0 by VD. So output voltage divided by the differential voltage. Since we are considering input voltage as differential voltage, that is open loop voltage gain is given by AOL. AOL means, OL indicates that open loop. A means gain. A gain, open loop voltage gain, which is given by output by input. Here the input is differential voltage, so we are going to write it as VD. So this is open loop voltage gain. That means we are going to consider op amp in open loop configuration. That means we are not giving any feedback to the op amp. That means we are not connecting the output to the input terminal for an operational amplifier. That is nothing but open loop. Next parameter is CMRR, common mode rejection ratio. As we have seen in the case of differential amplifier, this is also same as we have discussed in that differential amplifier, nothing but CMRR is equal to is the ratio of differential gain. It is the ratio of differential gain to the common mode gain. So differential gain is given by differential voltage and common mode gain depends upon the common mode voltage. You know that VC is the common mode voltage and as we have seen that differential gain is V0 by VD and the common mode gain will be V0 by VC. So here you can see that common mode gain AC is equal to V0 by VC. And CMRR is around based upon that typically the CMRR value for a 741 op amp is around 90 dB. And this is about the CMRR. Next parameter is output voltage swing. So see here, output voltage swing means nothing but the output of an op amp is going to change between two voltage levels, because here for an op amp we are giving two supply voltages, that is positive supply voltage as well as negative supply voltage. So for that reason, the voltage, whatever the signal we have given, is going to fluctuate between these two values. That means is going to change between these two values, nothing but. So that is it is going which is going to towards plus VCC, and in negative cycle it is going towards minus VEE. So if VCC and VEE are plus or minus 15 volts, then the saturation voltages will be plus or minus 13 volts. Next one is power supply rejection ratio, so which is also called as PSRR. So this power supply rejection ratio is given by, so see here you can see the formula. So PSRR is equal to change in VIOS, input offset voltage. VIOS is nothing but input offset voltage. It is a ratio of change in input offset voltage to the change in supply voltage, keeping other supply voltage as constant. This is what the statement. It is the ratio of change in input offset voltage due to the change in the supply voltage producing it, keeping other supply voltage constant. So it is also called as power supply sensitivity. It is also called as power supply sensitivity or supply voltage rejection ratio. So it can be also, it can also be written as change in VIOS to the change in VEE, keeping VCC constant. Next, PSRR is in the order of millivolts per volts or microvolts per volts, because this whatever in the numerator section, that is VIOS, is around millivolts or microvolts, and in the denominator it is around in volts. That is nothing but supply voltage which we are considering. For a 741 op amp, typically it will be around 30 microvolts per volts. So this is PSRR. Next, differential input resistance. So it is also called as input resistance of an operational amplifier. For 741 IC, it is around 2 mega ohms when we are using transistors. If we are using a FET, op amp has few giga ohms. If you are using field effect transistors, it will be around, it will be in the order of giga ohms. That means it is having high resistance, which provides a large gain. And next, coming to output voltage swing also we have completed. Next, transient response. This we have to consider. The output of any network is divided into two parts. You know that? That is a transient part and steady state part. So the transient part is a time dependent. That means it depends upon time. So see here, from if up to now, let us consider the for an op amp, it has we have not given any signal. Suddenly we have given a signal which is having some voltage. At t is equal to 0, it is going to change. Input voltage is going to change. But our op amp may not be in on state, may not respond quickly. It will take some time. So the time is called nothing but that response. The response of an op amp depends upon time. So this changing the value from one value to another value is nothing but transient part. So transient part, you can see this is the transient part, this is the transient part here, and this is the steady state part. After attaining steady state part, it will maintain the constant voltage. During transient part, it is going to change its voltage. It will be, so this is the signal we have given. For example, this is the signal, a constant DC voltage signal we have given. Let us assume like that. Then the output, the response of this op amp will be like this. It will, it may not increase its voltage suddenly. It will increase, it will rise its voltage slowly. And then after there, we can observe here a overshoot also. So after that is, there will be some oscillations and it will remain constant after some time. So this is called nothing but transient response, and it will attain steady state after some time. So the transient part is either exponential or oscillatory. This transient part, you can see that the transient part is here, you can see that the transient part is exponential form, exponentially increasing, and here you can see that the transient part is oscillatory. So it is going to oscillate between two voltage levels, that is a positive voltage level and a negative voltage level, and became constant here. So the transient part may be either exponential or oscillatory. So the rise time here, in the transient part, we are going to consider the rise time. So what is this rise time? The time required for a signal from changing its position from 10% of its value to the 90% of its value. So see here. So the rise time, the time required by the output of an op amp to rise from 10% of its maximum amplitude to the 90% of its maximum amplitude is nothing but the rise time. So this rise time decides the bandwidth and speed of an op amp. So this rise time is going to decide the bandwidth and op amp, then the bandwidth and speed of an op amp. If rise time is small, then the op amp performs very fast. If rise time is less, the op amp will be performing very slow. So here you can see, the if rise time is maximum, the bandwidth will be minimum, and if rise time is minimum, and vice versa, nothing but if rise time is minimum, the bandwidth will be maximum. So here peak overshoot is the maximum amount by which the output exceeds its final state. So here you can see the peak overshoot. So this is the maximum amount by which the output exceeds its final state. So this is the transient response. Next, coming to the last parameter, this one is slieve rate. Slieve rate, it is the maximum rate of change of output voltage with time. So it is a rate of change of output voltage with respect to the time, maximum rate of change of output voltage with respect to the time. So it is, this slieve rate decides how fast the output changes when input changes. So when the input signal for an operational amplifier is going to change, that will change the output also. Simultaneously, the output must change. So this is nothing but as the slieve rate. If the output does not change when the input changes, so then the difference between the change in the output time to the input time is nothing but the slieve rate. The slieve rate is also caused due to the limited charging rate of compensating capacitor. So there internally for an op-amp we are having a compensating capacitor. Due to that compensating capacitor, this slieve rate may occur. So when a high frequency signal is applied to a capacitor, voltage cannot change instantaneously. So when a high frequency signal is applied to a capacitor, voltage cannot change instantaneously. dVc by dt is equal to I by C. So slieve rate can also be given by the ratio of I max by capacitance value. So a small problem. So if 15 amperes is the maximum current given and 30 picofarads is the capacitance value, then slieve rate can be calculated with by knowing the maximum current and capacitance value. So it is a ratio of maximum current to the capacitance value. So the slieve rate is around 0.5 volts per microsecond. So these are the different characteristics of an operational amplifier. Up to now we have discussed about different characteristics of an operational amplifier, and next we are going to discuss about the equivalent circuit of op-amp. So see here, this is the equivalent circuit for an operational amplifier. So which is having, so here for an equivalent circuit we are going to consider input voltages. Rin is the input resistance, V1 is the one of the input voltage, and V2 is another input voltage. Nothing but here negative means this is inverting input. Here positive means this is non-inverting input. Inverting means nothing but you can say inverting means it is invert. Invert means it is negative. So inverting indicates that is 180 degrees out of phase. Nothing but. So this is non-inverting terminal and this is inverting terminal. These two are the inputs, and then this Rin is the input resistance for an operational amplifier. So this is dotted part is an op-amp, and plus VCC and minus VE are the supply voltages given for an op-amp. And then R0 is the output resistance for an operational amplifier, and it is open loop voltage gain, as we have studied it, AOL into VD. AOL is the open loop voltage gain and VD is the differential voltage. So this is the current gain for an operational amplifier. So this voltage gain into VD, AOL into VD. So output is equal to nothing but AOL into VD. Output is equal to AOL into VD. From the open loop voltage gain equation, we can write that AOL is equal to V0 by VD. So AOL into VD is equal to V0. So this is what, this is a voltage source here. So and we are going to take output across the load resistor RL. So AOL large signal voltage gain, VD differential voltage, that is the differential voltage here we are going to consider, V1 minus V2, and V1 is the non-inverting terminal, V2 is the inverting terminal, and RI is the input resistance and R0 is the output resistance. This is the equivalent circuit for an operational amplifier. So once you see this, so this is the equivalent circuit for an operational amplifier. Next, these all are about the characteristics for an operational amplifier. So next we are going for measurement of these parameters. Up to now what we have discussed are the parameters. How to measure some of the parameters, how to measure for an op-amp some of the parameters we are going to see. So mainly we are going to see how to measure this bias current and how to measure this measurement of input offset voltage and PSRR. Similarly, how to measure next we are going to see how to measure this a measurement of open loop voltage gain, and next we are going to see measurement of CMRR, and next we are going to see measurement of in differential input resistance RI, how to measure the differential input resistance RI. Next we are going to see output resistance R0, and measurement of total output offset voltage. What will be the output offset voltage when we are considering input offset voltages also. So next we are going to see measurement of slew rate. This is the last measurement. So these are the measurements we are having in this chapter. So one by one we will see. So first we are going to see the measurement of input equivalent circuit, measurement of input bias current. So this is a bias current. You can see here, for measuring the bias current, for measurement of this bias current, so we are going to consider this circuit. So the bias current is the average current. So already we have discussed that the bias current is nothing but IB1 plus, it is the average current, that is IB1 plus IB2 divided by 2. So for measuring that bias current, we are going to consider an operational amplifier, and we are connecting a resistor in between the output and resistor R, in between the output and inverting input terminal, as well as similarly parallel to that resistor we are going to connect a capacitor also. Here you can see that, so resistor and capacitor, which is going to feedback the output voltage to the input voltage. And next we are giving another one, is that is for an inverting terminal, it will be also grounded through a resistor R and C. Similarly a resistor R and C is connected to the non-inverting terminal as well as inverting terminal. Inverting terminal key, non-inverting terminal key, both the terminals we are making grounded with the help of a resistor and a capacitor parallel circuit. So the op amp closed loop configuration. So now we can say that the op amp is in a closed loop configuration. Why? Because here we are giving output signal to the input of an operational amplifier. That means a feedback is provided for an operational amplifier. When the feedback is provided, then it is said to be closed loop op amp. So here the capacitors are used for bypassing noises present in the operational amplifier. So first, for obtaining this IB1 and IB2, IB1 is the current flowing through this terminal, inverting terminal, and IB2 is the current flowing into the non-inverting terminal. So for obtaining IB1, we are making short node 1 and 2. So here you can see this 1 and 2. So node 1 and 2 will be grounded. So node 1 and 2 the ground. Node 1 ni manam, 2 ni, rendit ni kuda ground cheskuntam. Because of virtual ground concept, node 3 is also grounded. So when we are making one of the terminal to the ground, so that means ee terminal ganaka mana ground chesamo ante, so we are making this terminal also ground. So that this concept is called virtual ground concept. So when we are taking for an operational amplifier, if an non-inverting terminal is grounded, then inverting terminal may also be grounded, and this concept is called virtual ground concept. So due to that, because of this virtual ground concept, we can say that node 3 is also grounded. This is a node 3 is also grounded. So IB1 flow through the resistor R. Now this IB1 is the current, we can say that through the resistor R, the same current is going to flow through the resistor R, IB1. Virtual ground and chodam. What is the virtual ground? We will see now. It is a node of the circuit that is maintained at steady reference potential without being connected directly to the reference potential. That means we are not connecting here, we are making this terminal grounded, whereas we are not connecting this terminal to the ground, but we are assuming that terminal to be ground. So that concept is called virtual ground concept, without being connected directly to the reference potential. the referential potential may be either ground or earth. So this is called virtual ground concept. So by this we can say that the IBA1 is going to flow through the resistance R. Then we can write by using Ohm's law, we can write that IB1, so IB1 is the same current flowing through the resistance R. So we can say that IB1 into R is equal to V01. So output voltage is equal to IB1 into R. So IB1 is given by V01 by R. So if you know the output voltage, if you measure the output voltage with the help of a multimeter, then if you know the resistance value, we can measure the IB1, current IB1, that is a current flowing through the inverting input terminal. So similarly, for obtaining IB2, we are making 3 and 4 nodes to be grounded. So we are making these two. This is third node and this is fourth node. These two nodes in koda manam, these two nodes will be grounded. When these two nodes will be grounded, the same concept that IB2 is going to flow through the resistor R. And from that, we can write IB2 is equal to V02 divided by R. So V02 divided by R. So by making this IB2, IB1, E-terminal 3, 4 ni ground chesi, manam malli output, we are going to measure the output voltage with the help of a multimeter. So if you know the output voltage, that we are going to note down it as V02. And if you know, for calculating this IB2 value, V02 divided by R. Already we know the value of R, and if you measure the value of output voltage with the help of multimeter, we can obtain the IB2 current. So by obtaining these two, IB1 and IB2, the bias current IB can be the bias current. This is the bias current IB can be obtained, which is nothing but already we have studied that it is the average of two input currents. So IB can be obtained by IB1 plus IB2 divided by 2. So this is how we are going to measure the current for an the bias current for an operational amplifier. So here you can see this. So for this op amp, nothing but we are going to take an op amp and we are going to give the supply voltage, that's it, that is plus 12 volts and minus 12 volts, that's it. And we are going to connect a multimeter at the output terminal, and we are going to connect these resistor and capacitors. And first we are going to make this terminal to be grounded, pleasant ones, this terminal to be grounded. That means we are going to make a positive terminal to be grounded, and we are going to measure the current IB1. Then we are going to obtain IB1 with the help of V0 and R. And after that we are going to make this terminal to be grounded, 3 and 4 nodes to be grounded, and we are going to calculate the output, measure the output voltage with the help of multimeter, and that voltage we are considering as V02, and with the help of V02 divided by this resistance R, we are going to calculate this IB2. So if you know the value of IB1 and IB2, then we are going to get the value of the bias current, that is IB. So IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2 divided by 2. So this is how we are going to obtain the bias current. And we know that the input offset current can also be measured with the help of this IB1 and IB2. So nothing but for measuring input offset current, the formula is nothing but that is the difference between the two input currents. That is IB1 minus IB2 will give the input offset current. So here we are going to consider the magnitude, only magnitude, not we are not considering any polarity. So IIOS is equal to IB1 minus IB2. So this is how we are going to measure the input offset current as well as input bias current using for an operational amplifier. Next step.